It's Monday, 13th August, and this is Top Stories by Rooster News. Union Home Minister Rajnath Singh yesterday conducted an aerial survey of flood-ravaged Kerala and announced an immediate relief of Rs 100 crore as the state braced for yet another spell of heavy rain after a fresh low-pressure area developed in the Bay of Bengal. State authorities said that the death toll in the recent monsoon rose to 38 and more than 1 lakh people have been shifted to 1,026 relief camps. According to Mr. Singh, this has been the worst flood that the state has experienced since 1924. The tourism and agriculture sectors have suffered badly. Large tracts of paddy and cash crops and banana plantations were damaged. The infrastructure sector, including roads and buildings, were damaged and power lines also snapped, he said. Alaska's northern slope was hit yesterday by the most powerful earthquake ever recorded in the region, the state's seismologist said. At 6:58 a.m. yesterday, the magnitude 6.4 earthquake struck an area 67 kilometers east of Kavik River Camp and 551 kilometers northeast of Fairbanks, the state's second largest city. The U.S. Geological Survey says that the earthquake had a depth of about 9.9 kilometers. Later in the day, another magnitude 6.1 earthquake hit at 1:15 p.m. near the city of Kaktovik on Alaska's northern slope, the Geological Survey said. The Alaska Earthquake Center says that the earthquakes were felt across the eastern part of the state's northern slope borough and as far south as Metro Fairbanks. The center added that there were no reports of damage. The condition of former Lok Sabha Speaker Somnath Chatterjee continued to be critical yesterday after he suffered from a mild heart attack. Mr. Chatterjee has been on ventilation for the last 5 days after he was admitted to a private hospital in Kolkata last Tuesday due to kidney-related complications. He continues to be in critical but stable condition. Anything can happen when an 89-year-old man is suffering from total kidney shutdown and is on dialysis. We're trying our best, Pradeep Tandon, CEO of Bellevue Clinic, told reporters. Mr. Chatterjee was the speaker in the first five-year term, 2004 to 2009, of the United Progressive Alliance government and was elected to the parliament's lower house 10 times since 1971. He was expelled from the Communist Party of India Marxist or CPIM in July 2008 for refusing to resign as speaker after CPIM withdrew support from the United Progressive Alliance government. A Zambian man has been apprehended by the CISF at Delhi Airport for allegedly trying to smuggle out 24 kgs of drugs by concealing them in thigh pads used in cricket, a senior official said yesterday. R. Salavwe was intercepted on Saturday by security officials on the basis of suspicion at the Indira Gandhi International Airport. The Zambian national was travelling to Mumbai from Delhi and then to Addis Ababa in Ethiopia. A search of his bag led to the recovery of 46 cricket thigh pads which had the drug pseudoephedrine stuffed in them. All the thigh pads were found to have similar concealments in polythene pouches filled with the powdery drug and each of them weighed 500 grams, a senior official said. India's plan to put a human in space is just one decision away from being made a reality. In an exclusive interview, K. Shivam, chairman of space research organization ISRO, said that several of the critical technologies are already in place, including a crew module and a crew escape system. A prototype space suit has also been developed. ISRO is readying critical technologies for Indian human space program. If the government wants, the Indian astronaut program can be launched, said Mr. Sivan. Completing all the arrangements, however, could take 5 to 7 years, he said. Until now, only Russia, United States, and China have been able to conduct independent human space missions. ISRO has already carved out a niche in the commercial satellite launch market and has devised the cheapest successful Mars mission, Mangalyaan. A human space mission appears to be the next big step. With an eye on an ingenious effort to send an Indian to space, the ISRO had sought ₹12,500 crore from the government almost 10 years ago. But till date, it has only been receiving ₹173 crore made available for critical technology development. Signaling a go slow, Jitendra Singh, the minister in charge of India's space programs, told Parliament in 2016 that as of now, manned space program is not an approved program. We round up this newscast with fuel prices from key metros. In Delhi, petrol is sold for 77.10 rupees per litre and diesel for 68.54 rupees per litre. In Chennai, petrol is sold for 80.09 rupees per litre and diesel for 72.39 rupees per litre. In Kolkata, petrol is sold for 80.04 rupees per litre and diesel for 71.35 rupees per litre. In Mumbai, petrol is sold for 84.54 rupees per litre and diesel for 72.76 rupees per litre.